Business and Professional Women St. Kitts is a dynamic organization for business and professional women. Since its inception in 1975, the Business and Professional Women has supported and promoted women leaders and women's issues in St. Kitts while actively building partnerships, encouraging friendships, and communicating among our members. BPW St. Kitts is an affiliate to the BPW International, which is an organization that has a close relationship with the United Nations as well as other international organizations in their work to advance the role of women.
Whenever there's a crisis, no matter where in the world, women and girls are more negatively affected than men and boys. This is because of the structural inequalities that are so firmly fixed in place in many societies. Across this series, we introduce you to a range of women from professional backgrounds such as medicine, business and employment, lifestyle, and therapeutic counselling. Hopefully, these women will be providing answers to many of the questions that you may have that you can use as short-term or long-term solutions to the issues that you are now facing as part of the COVID-19 pandemic.
The COVID-19 pandemic is being labeled as a double plague for women and children because of its association with the worldwide increase in domestic abuse. The United Nations has had an urgent response to what has effectively become a shadow pandemic alongside COVID-19. Current estimates are that there have been an increase of between 20 to 40% of cases during the lockdown as many people are trapped at home with their abuser. It is recognized formally as a global issue, but it is not going unnoticed by other professionals who are practicing community medicine.
So we need to highlight the fact that we have women that are being abused daily, the abuse which can be in form of physical, in form of emotional, verbal, and even sexual abuse. These women have no safe place to go due to the lockdown, that most especially when they are living with their partners or whoever the person is that is abusing them. They have no safe place to go, so they are stuck in the system or in the circle of abuse and the effect of the abuse is just being aggravated due to the effect of the virus.
Also, I would like to look into the case of the issue of domestic violence. You see, a woman who lives in a very abusive home environment, either due to the fact that there is physical distance restriction or probably financial dependence or just not being able to stay out of that zone at that point in time, it's hard for her to be able to relieve herself or detach herself from the issue of domestic violence, and so it occurs and erupts occasionally.
Another problem that I see surfacing as well would be an increase in domestic violence, where our women, because of the quarantine procedures and measures, because of the restriction of movement, our females and our young girls are trapped with pedophiles and sexual molesters. And to make matters worse, our young women, and due to the economic insecurity, in the form of job losses, cannot move around, cannot leave, because if they do so, poverty ensues or poverty increases, so they are now forced to stay with their abusers. Even if they are strong enough to reach out to the health system our health system as it is currently is solely focused on getting over the pandemic. There is no national response for women and children and girls who are abused during the pandemic.
Gathers data on violence against women from countries all over the world. And all of the nations of the OECS have challenges with regard to implementing significant developments to the social and justice systems to ensure lasting changes are made to protect women and children from violence. The cumulative effect of these stresses can affect anyone's mental health.
It's consistent with series of issues of loss of interest, like anhedonia, loss of energy, sleep deprivation, loss of concentration. Also, you notice the lady is feeling worthless. Or basically, also, you could see the issue of feeling incomplete. So, but my advice, of which she asked in that question, what should she do? Concerning what she was going through. Due to the pandemic, it would be so hard for her to visit a doctor because to make appointments and all could be very, very restricted.
However, the coronavirus have just highlighted the cracks that were already there and have compounded the problems we as females face in our daily lives. One of the problems as a doctor I see surfacing would be the challenge to hold our mental status, our mental health together. From since the beginning of times, women are the glue factor in our families, in our societies, in our communities, in our nation. We keep our families together. However, that comes with a price. We become drained. Our mental capabilities are stretched, are overstretched, are stretched so thinly that they have now become transparent. And when this occurs, what happens? We become frustrated. We become tired. We are on edge. We don't function. We become nervous. And this in itself puts a strain on the family structure and fabric. So this mental capability, which is often overlooked by the health system, it's a real issue for our women.
Women are more likely to be victims of trauma. Feeling off balance now is normal. It is normal to feel a little stressed out. It's normal to feel a lot stressed out. During this time, there are generally some things that I advise for all people in all situations, but breathing exercises can be wonderfully powerful. Taking that deep inhale in and releasing that exhale can make a big difference. It might seem so silly and it might seem so hokey, but I promise you, if you can take 10 slow breaths to yourself, it can help reset you. I really want us to think about how what we can control. We don't have a lot of areas of control in our life. Well, it feels like things are out of control, but there are some areas we can control. We have to be careful about substances like alcohol, like marijuana. These are very common go-tos to help us deal with our moods. But I try to encourage people to think, if we're turning to something to control our mood, we're not developing the skill to manage our moods ourselves. If you find that things are really overwhelming, that you really have having difficulty managing, there are professional counselors who can help you with this. Professional counselors, psychologists, the counseling center is available. There are resources available for mental health on the island. There are government options, there are private options, and the St. Kitts Mental Health Association, their Facebook page, has all the information you'll need about anyone you can access if you really are feeling like things are too much.
Take good care of yourself. If you need a life coach, a counselor, don't be shy. If you need to go to your pastor, your friends, talk. Don't keep everything inside so that at night you are restless. Exercise, eat right, stay off of sugar, salt, dairy, all of the things that make your blood acid and you unable to help yourself.
Just finding ways to connect with other people. Because if this pandemic has taught us anything, we have to be flexible. So what we expect of people in the past, or what people have given us in the past, we might not be getting it now.
We hope that you found some useful ideas to help you cope with any stress in your life. Wine, ain't got no money.